Hi, welcome to my channel. My name is Wayne and you're watching part 3 of the art process video for Saturn, the Hard Teacher. Please enjoy.
A good deal of people from all sorts of ethnicities are searching for meaning outside of the parameters of Western culture. In today's fast-paced world, how many universally accepted tried-and-true rites of passage do we have to demarcate the passage from one age or era of our lives onto the next? I can think of maybe one or two things that are case-specific, like fraternal organizations, social clubs, martial arts, sports, or maybe some significant ones within family structures like sweet 16s for girls or quinceañeras. The most generalized one that seems to apply to a greater portion of society is our educational institutions, but even then, not everybody has the same access to it and have the same quality of instruction. An initiatic rite of passage is a coming-of-age event that usually involves a trial through one or more of the elements, sometimes literally, sometimes symbolically, sometimes both. And upon successfully completing these tests, the individual who has submitted themselves to this process typically gains some new awareness, new level of thinking, being, perceiving, and interacting with the world. And more than likely as a result of this, they are usually granted new permissions and have new accesses or privileges that they didn't have before. The educational system, as I said, is perhaps the most universal system that performs rites of passage large scale. Then next to that, maybe religious institutions, which vary, of course, on how that information is transmitted. I've seen a shift where a good deal of people are looking now to ancestral traditions to fill some of those gaps that those other places don't cover. Whether it's African, Nordic, Asian, Indian, Indigenous American, folk, or some other practice, maybe even an eclectic mix of some of those mentioned. And it's interesting that many of these traditions have some cosmological perspective as well. I find it fascinating that the planets and the stars have such a large-scale impact on our activities as human beings. As with all of the planets, the symbolism of Saturn has initiatic qualities, and it's certainly true how that plays out with the whole trials and tribulations thing, depending on the octave of the planet that's impacting you. Then of course there's the submission aspect, because the archetype demands that you submit to its decrees in order to learn, or in order for it to impart its lessons. And if you look at it like a forced submission, then it might seem cold and harsh and cruel. But if you look at it as a willful submission, with the individual taking on a passive state, resonating now with the archetype of the High Priestess, then the voice that guides you as you silence your ego is that of your intuition.
Well, that's my opinion anyway. Thank you for watching. Please remember to like and subscribe. You're greatly appreciated. My name is Wayne Rodney, artist and illustrator and creator of the Global Fusion Intuitive Tarot Deck, published by US Games Systems. I've left a link to the cards in the description of this video. Thank you once again and have a wonderful day.